industry and to really understanding. And so I say this is the good versus the bad. And ultimately, in a healthy mouth, we want the good to be balancing out the bad. And so this is the most important piece when we're looking at the bacteria in your mouth is which is outnumbering which, what is actually present there. And so we're looking at health versus disease. I want to take a moment on this slide because a lot of us talk about, and I'm going to talk about it too today, about all the bad bacteria. But I want to take a moment for you to really look at what's happening here with health versus disease. Is what we forget to look at is what isn't present. Because in a healthy periodontium, in a healthy oral microbiome, we have very specific bacterial species. And then you see these core species that overlap. And then we have periodontal species. The problem is when we have these periodontal species, we no longer have these healthy species. So that's why I want to create a pause there is a lot of times what we don't talk about is what is missing. We have to have the good bacteria there to actually bring back balance. And so we fight bacteria with bacteria. So let's take a look at how we can do that. And so this is just another great article showing you the science of how we start. And this process is important. The process of periodontal disease or infection in the mouth is very important to understand that we start with a healthy microbiome. That healthy microbiome then has a very distinct process that grows into what we call core species that grows into periodontal disease. Well, where do these species live? Well, this is important because this is how probiotics work. We have to understand where the bacteria grow. So we have very specific digestive bacteria, which we just learned from Dr. Pritchard. We give certain probiotics to heal and repair the gut and repopulate it. And then we have periodontal bacteria. And this is a patented product that actually has three species that grow around the periodontal pocket, adhere to the tissue, and as well to the tooth surface. And then we have species of probiotics or strains that are ear, nose, and throat, or some people say sinus. So we have to really know what species to give our patient or which species are doing which activity. These are some of the most common strains through our commercial products. So you can see when you look at those products, they tell you the strains. What we need to do as dental colleagues in oral medicine is know which strains are going to grow where, or better yet, fight and bring back balance. They've got to fight off those bad bacteria. So let's talk about BLIS strains. Those of our Salveris, our K12, M18. We have L. reuteri, our L. planetarium, paracasei, acidophilus. You hear about these all the time. And you can see in that screenshot, they are in tons of products. So they get labeled, they're out there, you can use them. What you need to know is when would I use these? And so this is becomes really important because lots of patients, and we hear this with gut health as well, is that I'm on a probiotic. I take a probiotic. Well, now we're talking about oral probiotics, and that's even more specific because oral probiotics, these species are only for ear, nose, and throat. And then we say teeth, which means decay strains. And these are the orange and green complex bacteria. So these species are going to fight those orange and green zones. When we're talking about Oralis, Uberus, and Radius, these strains are very important because now we're talking about periodontal disease. So we're talking about the periodontal pocket. We're talking about the tissues. Of course, we're talking about the T strains as well with decay. But what's so profound here with this is that these strains are going to fight our high-risk pathogens. So now we're talking about our red, our purple, and blue complex bacteria. So we can see through their study, how does that happen? And this is just what we started with. This is the good fighting the bad. We want to overpopulate, reseed with good so that they can help bring that balance back. And in this, we're actually seeing in the petri dish, you look here, disease plaque versus a healthy plaque. You see those clear zones. This is what bacteria do. They fight for food and space. And a lot of these will give off naturally. You see that clear zone. So they're actually fighting against those bad bacteria. And so these strains are very important to understand and know when we're talking about periodontal disease. We want to make sure that we're looking for the S. aurelis or that KJ3. We want to be looking for, I'm going to have you go back to that slide. Thank you. For the uveris. And then right when we're talking about dental decay or cavities, that we're looking for that radis. Perfect. So this product you're probably asking about if you've never heard about it, right? Is it safe? Absolutely, right? We know that it grows this healthy biofilm for us, but what's more importantly is that we have science behind it. And it's been backed by over 35 years of research and it's been over 10 years in use. And so you can look for ProBiora Pro. It is only distributed through the dental professionals community. So that's us. It's very hard for our patients sometimes to get a hold of it. But what's more important is that it comes in this strength and a 90-day, I say, treatment. So a lot of us, we're doing our treatment. We want to put our patients on that periodontal maintenance, or we're going to see them at that 3-month appointment that they have enough product till they see us next. And that's a huge benefit to our success. So let's take a look at probiotics. We're talking about this increased awareness and relationship. And what this says is this is really between the host and the oral microbiome. It's providing these insights that actually help promote symbiosis. And so this is what we want to be doing, not only in the gut, but in the mouth. And when we can actually give the body what it needs, we see that healing happening. So you should be asking yourself, well, how would I know which strain to use? How do I know if these pathogens are present? Bad bacteria, we give them the name of pathogens. Not all bacteria are bad. That's why we have the name of probiotics. But what I want you to be asking, okay, how would I know? So we're going to follow the same model. We're going to test, we're going to treat, and we're going to repopulate. And so now we have this amazing test called HR5. It is testing for those specific red, purple, and blue complex that I just talked about. So they are the 5 high risk. FN is actually our bridge. And so it is in that core species or orange zone. But we know if we have these 5 high risk that, right, we have a very pathogenic biofilm going on. So why these 5? Well, number one, we can help predict disease. Just like our colleagues in medicine, we want to be able to predict, we want to be able to prevent, and we want to be able to personalize. That's what we just talked about, everything here with knowing which strains to use and how to help this patient is that it needs to be about personalized care. And then, of course, we want to look to the oral side, oral systemic side of how this affects the entire body.